Whether you're a clerk or a waiter, an accountant or a doctor, your health matters.
Hello everyone. Welcome to this week's edition of Your Health Matters. I'm your presenter, Dr. Tasila Tembo Peters. On today's program, we take you to Levi Mwanawasa General Hospital, where expert Dr. Felista Yavwa will explain more about obesity and how it can be prevented. We now start with views from the public.
Obesity ni matenda ajakutati muntu aina ko pitirira vija ero mameni zibirako nga mameni abwerera na voku development madi vija monga vama junk food vija pezeka muntu aina kupitirira vija
ma factors nyambiri maningi amene anga causing obesity one kudya chidiye mostly ma junky foods amena ya kuti ma chips and sausage chicken and chips ma chani something like that ma, then na lack of exercise muntu such to exercise something like that
obesity is a kind of bad nutrition, although most people only know that underweight is the malnutrition or bad nutrition, but obesity is also a form of malnutrition. This occurs when the body index mass is more than 30. What we mean by that is you have this person who is extremely overweight beyond what is normal by definition by WHO. So once that is abnormal, it means that it cannot work well within the limits of health. On the other hand, the simplest way of explaining obesity is that you have increased calories against reduction in burning those calories. So there's no balance between the increase in calories. This increase in calories could be pathological, or it could be just somebody who's just overeating, and then they are not able to burn those calories. They are not exercising or working out. So therefore, obesity is a form of disease. The age groups that are affected include both the children and the adults. It is genetic in some people, but in some people it is not. And we also have some causes in some people. For example, people who have certain disease conditions called low thyroid, they can have which is called hypothyroidism, they can be obese. You also have people who have problems with the satiety center. If there's a tumor, for example, in the brain, that leads to uncontrolled eating by this kind of a person, not because of their own making, but because there's a pathological problem, then they tend to be obese. And you also have conditions again, like Cushing's syndrome, which is also a metabolic problem, which also leads to that kind of increase in weight. Those who take alcohol, they're the ones who have an increased, trunk or obesity, more or less like increased weight centrally compared to the peripheries. Peripheries meaning the legs and the hands. It is now coming as a double burden of diseases. We are having infections, and we are having, on the other side, diseases associated with the obesity. For example, a person who is obese is likely to suffer from diabetes type 2. Is likely to suffer from heart conditions called ischemic heart diseases, reduced blood flow to the heart, in short. They are predisposed to cancers as well. They are prone to have osteoarthritis, and apart from that, they can even have gout. Obesity also causes sleep apnea. Now, sleep apnea is a complication which happens when obese people sleep at night, and because of the fats around the neck, they tend to collapse the windpipe. Now, that tends to build up a lot of red blood cells, means that the blood becomes a little bit thicker than usual. And once the blood is thicker, which we call high viscosity, this leads to certain complications which can be fatal, like a stroke. People think that obesity is a form of wealth. It's like a marker that people are well. They are well to do, they have a lot of money, or they have well, you know, like good health. It's actually the opposite. They actually have bad health. Obesity is very prevalent here in Zambia. So we should look at it like the way we look at infections, such that we should start thinking of how to prevent it.
We have clients who come and you tell them that, no, this weight is not okay. They would even refuse to say, no, me, I'm fine. I do this, I do that. But when we do our calculations, we find that that person is overweight and there is need for them to reduce.
Obesity is becoming a problem in Zambia, and I cannot overemphasize the diet. Well, we should not shift from the natural diet that we've been eating of legumes and vegetables and less of fat and less of protein. Now, with a lot of highly refined foods, and those tend to be cheaper on the market, and they're fast foods, they're readily available, they're cheaper, people tend to go for them. So we should start moving away from that and try to find time to have, you know, a balanced diet, for example, where in a plate you have maybe half the plate is vegetables, the other half is divided into protein and energy.
Others would accept, if we do our assessment, would accept that they are obese and they are willing to start the program on nutrition. When they come now, we do our counseling, then we give them the dietary advice. Then after that, we give them appointments to be coming, let's say every month or every after 2 weeks.
After measuring somebody's body mass index, we prescribe physical activities that help people to maintain a normal body mass index so that they are able to expend the food that they eat without unnecessarily saving the energy in form of fat. Where we identify people that are obese, we come in to help them burn the excess fat that is sitting in their body, because there are complications with excess weight, because your heart will struggle to pump blood through the fat tissue, because the fat tissue also cover your blood vessels. Therefore, your blood vessels will be narrowed because of the fat.
So therefore, it's incumbent upon the patients or people, when they notice that they are getting obese, the measuring of weight is cardinal, so that you know that you are now going into the danger zone. But for those with a genetic predisposition, the delay in onset of obesity can be done.
Well, viewers, you now know that obesity can be prevented. To prevent it, make sure you eat healthy and drink healthy. Involve yourselves in regular exercises, and also, when you have obesity, please visit your nearest health facility at the physiotherapy department, where you will receive counseling. Avoid toxic habits like smoking and drink alcohol in moderation. This has been Dr. Tasida Tembo Peters on Your Health Matters. From me, stay healthy.
It matters, your health matters. It matters, oh. Whether you're a student or a mother, a lawyer.